Hey guys, today we're gonna talk about parking on an incline. Today we're gonna go over best practices for parking on an incline. It's a very basic thing and we all go through it when we get our licenses, but lately I've been seeing people not doing the best practices. So we're gonna simulate that. So right now we have a brake application you can see and the vehicle's in drive. We're simulating us parking on an incline right now. So we're gonna put the vehicle into neutral first. Now we're gonna apply our parking brake, our emergency brake. The next thing we're gonna do is we're going to let go of our foot brake to verify that our parking brake is engaged. So you've let go. Vehicle's in neutral. If the parking brake was not working properly, the vehicle would begin to roll back. It is not doing that right now. So now we can go ahead and put it into park. This is the best practice in my view because we're not putting so much pressure onto the transmission. If we just put it into park and then let go and then apply the parking brake, we're putting a little bit of strain on the transmission when we don't need to. So I'm going to show you guys what it sounds like when you just put into park. So we're just going to put into park right now, all the way. Now we're going to let go of the brake slowly. So the vehicle's moved back, now it's on the transmission. I want you guys to listen now. Put into reverse. Hear that big clunk? Yeah, that's not so great for the transmission. Now we're going to do our old procedure. So we're going to put in neutral, apply the parking brake. Now we're gonna put it into, let go of the brake. Now we're on the parking brake assembly. Now we're in park. Now again, I want you to release the, put your foot on the brake, release the parking brake first. Put it into reverse. See how smooth that is? We'll do it again. I'll put the camera down here so you guys can listen. So neutral, parking brake applied, now into park. Now do a brake application, release the parking brake, now let's put in reverse. Move it back a bit. Okay, so you guys hear that there's no clunk because we're not putting any strain on the transmission. If you want to own your vehicle for a long time, use that procedure. Just don't put into park and then let go of the brake and have all the vehicle's weight on the transmission. Not so good for it. So do this again from a driver's perspective. I really hate hearing that clunking noise and I hear so many people do it. So bad for the transmission. Like, yes, the transmission is designed to take it, but like that big clunking sound, does it really sound good to you? So I'm in reverse right now, neutral, applying the parking brake, letting go of the brake, vehicle's holding, not moving, turn my wheel to the appropriate, which way do I want it to go? You know, in this case, I guess I'd want it to go into the wall, I guess, and then go into park. So here we have a curb, or simulated curb, and we are going to simulate parking the vehicle as if something were to fail in the drivetrain and the parking system. So right now we're just going to put in a neutral. We're going to let go of the brake a little bit. You'll see it roll back. We're on an incline. Okay. Show you we're now in reverse. Put in neutral. Neutral. Let go of the brake. Okay, so we see the vehicle roll back. We are on an incline. So let's move the vehicle forward again. Keep going. And stop. So if we are going to park on an incline facing up on the road, so if we are, this is the side away from the driver. So for those of you that live in an area where your driver's seat is on the passenger side for us, so you're on the right side of the vehicle, you're gonna follow the same thing. You're just gonna point the wheel, have it come towards the curb. So right now, because we're facing up, we're gonna point the wheel left, 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 left. Okay, now we're gonna put the vehicle in the neutral. Let go of the brake slowly. So we're off the pedals, we're in neutral. Engine's running because we want to have more control over the vehicle. We want to make sure that our brake booster is filled with vacuum. We have vacuum at our brake booster in case that's why we're doing this demonstration with the engine running. So we're in neutral. There's nothing holding this truck on the incline but this. So that we can do if we have a curb over here. But Let's bring the vehicle forward a bit. Straighten out the wheel. If there is no curb, we do not want to point the wheel that way because the vehicle will go into oncoming traffic. So let's just demonstrate that. Turn the wheel all the way left. So we're gonna simulate not having a curb. We do not want to do this in this situation. Roll back slowly. So you can see the truck starting to veer off this way. If it continues to go, it's gonna go into that wall, or we're gonna pretend that oncoming traffic is coming this way. We do not want that. Let's put the vehicle back over here. So up an incline, we point the wheel away from the curb, but we're pointing the back wheels that are rolling into the curb. So pointing upwards with a curb, away. Now, if there is no curb, we're gonna turn the wheel right. So now we're gonna go into the curb or into the ditch. Let's pretend this is a ditch over here. So if our vehicle parking system fails, we don't want to be in the way of oncoming traffic. If our vehicle gets wrecked, it's our vehicle only, but we wanna go into the ditch. So we're gonna now neutral, let it roll back. So you see now the truck is veering towards the ditch. So this is what we would want to happen. That way we keep other motorists safe. Okay, we now have the vehicle facing down an incline. So passenger side is closest to the curb. We're just gonna simulate in neutral, roll it forward. Vehicle just rolls forward. Okay, bring it back. Stop right there. Okay, we're gonna turn the wheel now toward the curb. Okay, neutral, you're neutral. Okay, let go of the wheel, let go of the brake slowly. So you see, no brake application. All the weight is held by this tire. So we're going into the curb. Now, I don't have to explain, if there was no curb, it would just go into our ditch or off to the side. So when facing down an incline, we're going to turn into the curb or away from oncoming traffic no matter what. So the vehicle is just going to go over here. But if there ever is a curb, you want to utilize it as much as possible. So we always have to think of where the curb is, because let's say you're parking in a one-way street. You can't just think, oh, I always point right or I always point left. You have to think and know which way your vehicle is going to roll. So, you know, put your vehicle into neutral and turn it a little bit and feel which way it's going to roll. So if the vehicle's down a hill and we want it to roll this way, well, we obviously point the wheel this way. The only time we point the vehicle away from the curb is if it's facing up and there is a curb over here for us to rest on. If you're really not sure, then yes, just always point the wheel towards the curb. If it's going up or down, it's going to go in that direction. Now, the reason why I'm assuming, like, this is just taught to us in driving school and from pretty much how the government set it up for the driver licensing office here in Canada. I'm pretty sure it's pretty universal across the world, but correct me if I'm wrong in your area. If you're pointing up, the back wheel stays straight. So I'm assuming the reason why they want you to point the wheel away from the curb so that the back part of the front wheel will hit the curb is, if this is straight rolling down and you go into the curb, it's very possible that this will just ride the curb and the vehicle might still keep going down, or it might wreck the wheels as well. So that's the only reason I can see why in that only particular situation, uphill with a curb, you point the wheels away from the curb is to stop it, because these front wheels are parallel with it. And it's probably just gonna ride down a little bit. You might, you know, it might go a few feet and it's in the vehicle behind you. Okay, so here is a document from Ontario, Government of Ontario, ontario.ca. I will link this in the video for you guys. So we go scroll down to section 3. So here it says, when parking facing downhill, turn your front wheels toward the curb with right shoulder. This will keep the vehicle from rolling into traffic. So that's this one over here. Curb or without curb, you're facing it toward, away from oncoming traffic, so toward the curb. I'm trying to keep in mind that there are other people that watch these videos that have the driver's side on the opposite side of us. You see, turn the wheel left so the wheels are turned toward the road if you're facing uphill with a curb. That's the big one, with a curb. So the tires will catch the curb if it rolls backwards. So like we showed before with the truck, catches the curb, just stops. I know this is where it kind of gets confusing for you guys, but like, because here is the only situation where you face, where it's going towards traffic, but that's because that curb's gonna stop it. So here, when facing uphill without a curb, sharply to the right, that way it's gonna veer this way away from traffic. The whole objective of parking in any of these scenarios is if something fails, the vehicle does not go into oncoming traffic. So here in North America, traffic is coming down this way. We do not want that vehicle coming out this way or going down. We want to stop it. That's why it's so important to turn your wheels when you're parking on an incline. So yeah, guys, those are basic things I think most people know. The biggest thing for me is putting into neutral first, applying the parking brake or the emergency brake, and then put it into park or into gear if you have a manual transmission. We have another video where we have a Mazda 3. It's a very low compression engine. If it's parked in gear, it actually does go down this incline. So we cannot rely strictly on parking a vehicle in gear. We like to use a combination of parking in gear and park, and also using the parking brake mechanism. So yeah, big thing is put in neutral. Make sure your parking brake mechanism actually works, because a lot of people don't have it adjusted and it does need adjustment over time. And some people just automatically assume like it's gonna work. By doing this practice, you know that the parking brake does work. So in an emergency, if you ever need to use it, you know it's gonna help you out. So if you guys are still unsure, it's a little bit confusing even after this demonstration, you know what? Just go in your driveway, find an incline not near anyone, grab a 2x4 and practice. Practice putting the vehicle in the neutral and turning the wheels and get a feel for where the vehicle is going to go. That way you know how it's going to react with the curb. And remember, guys, whenever doing any type of maneuvers on public roadways, that you're always checking your surroundings, check your mirrors, check all around you, do your 360 checks before moving the vehicle.
If you like today's content, make sure to check out my channel and hit the subscribe button, and make sure to hit that bell notification. What that does is it makes sure that you're always kept up to date with all the content that we're providing with you guys on YouTube. So the way that we have the channel set up is I have the uploads up top. That way, at all times, you can always see, if you just hop by the channel, what our latest upload is. Plus with the bell notification, you're going to get some sort of message from YouTube itself. We also have popular uploads, car videos, how-to videos, demonstration and informational videos, and a lot of cool other specific car videos like our builds playlist. I really like the builds playlist because it takes all the theories from our how-to section and it keeps applying it to different vehicles. Yeah.